Today topic is concept of pulse width modulation PWM based inverter. In this I will tell you how DC is getting converted into AC with the help of PWM. Here I have shown one simple power circuit of inverter for single phase. These 1, 2, 3, 4 are IGBT, but I have shown as a switch because IGBT will work like a switch. At present, all 4 switches are shown open. When I want to close, I will do like this. So this is closed position, this is open position. This is load and this is DC supply or input DC. Our object is to convert this AC into this type of AC using IGBTs. Here I have shown this point as M, not this point. We are free to call any point as a M. Here, I have shown two DC sources, say both are 12 volt. But in this case, I am calling this negative terminal as a M, in this case positive terminal as a M. If this is M or 0 volt, this will be plus 12 volt. If plus terminal is M or 0 volt, the negative terminal will be minus 12 volt. But here also, this voltage is 12 volt more than this. Here also, voltage of this point is more than this by 12 volt. Only method of indicating M is different. This is time scale, this is voltage scale, and this shows at what time I am discussing. First we will generate plus side voltage, afterward we will generate negative side voltage. Now at this time t is equal to 0, all switches are open, so we get 0 volt. This plus side voltage we will generate using this red color switch, these two. Negative side green color we will generate using these two, green color switch or IGBT. Now here both switches are open, so this is 0 volt. Now what we do, at this point, here we will close these two switch. So I am closing. At this point. Now, how the connection will be there? Like this. So, circuit is completing. If this is M, this point is connected to plus voltage, so we get plus. From this time to this time, we will keep the switch on. At this time, we will open both the switch. So we are here now. Voltage at this point again has become 0 because both are open. Now at this time, again we will close. So when we close, again we will get voltage at output. This point will be plus. So we get plus here. From here to here, we'll keep these both switches on. At this point, we will switch off again, both the switches. So from here to here, switch were on, so we get voltage. Here we get 0. Like that, we will go on doing. Here, say at this point, again we will switch. And from this time to this time, we'll keep both switch on. So from here to here, we get voltage. Here again we will open, so we get 0 volt. Like that, we will go on doing. Now here you see at this point, our voltage requirement is more. So we keep this switches on for longer time from here to here. At this point, voltage requirement is less. So we keep this switches on for shorter time. Here also, voltage requirement is less. So on period is less, off period is more. Now to generate this, we will use this switch. These two will remain open. So at this point, we will switch these two switches on. Now what happens? We are assuming M as a zero. So this point voltage will be negative, because this point is connected here. So we get minus voltage here. So we are getting minus here. And this point is connected to plus. Just some time back I explained you, if you connect this as a zero, this will be negative. From here to here, we will keep this switch on. And at this point, again we want 0 volt, so we will keep switch open. Like that, when we come here, we will make it on. We get negative voltage. And at this point, again we will open. So again we get 0. Like that, we will go on doing. Here, voltage requirement is more, so we will keep switches on for longer time, these two now. Here, these two. Here, voltage requirement is less, so switch are on for shorter time. So like that, different width pulse we will get. Now here, to control the output voltage, we are controlling the width of pulse. These are pulse, but having different width. So it is some kind of modulation of width. So we call it pulse width modulation, because by controlling the width of pulses, we are controlling the output. Where voltage is more, width is more. When voltage is less, width is less. Now output wave shape is like this, pulse type. If you take the average of this time wise, you get something like this. But to get very close to sine wave, we connect a filter here. When we connect a filter, we can get a better quality of sine wave. This is when resistor load is connected. When motor is connected, filter requirement is not that much. Some smaller size we can put, because inductance inside the motor behaves like a filter. Now, this is filter. Here, there will be diode like this. This is called the freewheeling diode. The diode is connected across all IGBT. I have not shown. I am showing only one now. Now this I have shown for single phase. Here you are seeing there are two branch. If you want three phase, there will be one more branch. And total IGBT will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is the minimum. Using 6 IGBT, we can get the 3-phase output voltage. But concept is same. Today we will close now.